Yes, there. Feel that? Right there. Got better. It's not much rounder, but just a little bit rounder in his neck. Yes. That's going to make a big difference then. Yeah, and upbeat. Come on. Come on, go. Yeah. Uh-huh. Good. And pattern. Fine. Good. Okay. Very good.
And then go back to a large circle. And upbeat. Yes. Yes. And a little bit more bend for a moment. All you have to do is squeeze your fingers together, like squeezing a sponge. Hold it. And back off. Relax. And then repeat. Yeah, close your outer hand at that same moment. So hold the left leg tight, push, bend the right, 3-4 steps, then back up. Yeah. Yes, very good. Very good. Just air. We can stay down here on the circle, close your outside hand, and go. Yeah, close your outside hand. Yeah, good.
Same thing in the hand, but a little bit over tempo.
So more than what he wants to give you. Yeah. Ask for a few steps, meeting.
And then back up.
Yes,
be passive, just sit there.
Very good. Very good. Uh-huh, very good.
Make sure that your outside arm doesn't become straight and the elbow to your elbow, got?
Super.
And then down to the shin drop.
Just use your voice a little bit.
Close your outside hand, leg on.
Yes, and trot. When you're ready. Good. Super. Super. And then canter when you're ready.
Take your time. Take your time. Take your time.
Get organized. Yes.
When you ask for the canter, try to close your outside hand at that moment. So hold the outside hand a little tighter. Just don't bend them to the outside. And push them on. Down on.
Yep. Good. And down position.
Nice. Get a little bit lighter for a moment on the inside. Relax your arm for a moment. And then 10 centimeters back. And then pressure on the outside leg. And knee it. Go. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Very good. Bring your leg more strong enough. You still want to hold a little more on the outside leg. Right? At the transition to canter, his leg stays rounder.
Yeah, and push him up.
Yeah, and push. Come on. Go, go, go. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then. That frame is better. He could still be a little bit rounder, but this is pretty nice already.
Yeah, so the part in front of you, the neck, that's easy because you can take with the hands, you can tighten the reins, and, well, if you apply enough pressure, sooner or later, he's hopefully going to give in, right? Unless he's really stiff. The problem with that is, the more you pull, the slower he wants to go. So if you close here, it doesn't mean that he necessarily gets more of an arc and becomes shorter and lighter. He just sticks his butt out behind you and goes slower. Yeah, so you have to push him on. That's why he goes so much forward, a little bit over forward right now, because he wants to be so strong here. Yeah. So it's the pushing him on from behind, and the restricting in the front, and the release. So the release is really important. It's not just how much you can push and hold; it's the combination of that and the release at the right moment. So timing and finesse is a big part of it, even when you're strong. Okay. You can add a little bit of bend, especially when you're on a circle or when you go through the chorus, that helps, but it's not what makes them rounder, okay? So bending helps you make your driving, your pushing, and your restricting in the front a little bit easier, okay? But don't think that bending in is what's gonna make them rounder, okay? All right, let's pick them up again. Why don't we do just a little bit legier?
You can just do it at the wall. You can do it across the arena. You can do it from the center line out from the rail into the center line. You can do it down the long side, facing the wall, any which way you like.
Exercise where you can aids that we were just talking about. You're pushing your arm from your right leg mostly, and you're holding it on your outside leg. And with your right leg, make sure that it doesn't look to the left. So he has to still look to the right. Look at that again. Left brain thinks, the left brain catches him. Yeah? Yeah? Both brains together make him go, both aids, the left brain and the right leg, make him go forward sideways and also round up. Yes. Take a little more on the outside wing. Get hold of it, two steps. So we'll tap a whip and then back off. Yes. Good. We do it one more time at the walk and then we'll do it at the trot. You can shorten your reins like this much. It's not even a centimeter. Down the middle here, down the center. Go down the center line. And now right leg back in. See if you can ride a peak. Yes. Give a little kicking with a whip. There you go. Good. Very good. Let's go to sitting trot. Let's do that at the trot. Good. When you arrive on the track, transition, walk. Now close your left hand even more. Take on the outside rail, walk. And right back to trot, set the line again. Same thing. Good. And go. Yeah. Good. Now closing your left hand. It's like squeezing a sponge. So squeeze, hold for a moment. One, two, three, and then get light. Relax. And then again, squeeze on the left fist, drive in your right leg, and relax and walk. Good. And move over. Fine. Very good. Very good. Don't forget about the temple. Yeah, this guy has to go a little extra forward. Yes. Okay, then find the serpentine. We'll do a serpentine. We'll do four loops. So we end up going track left. Yeah, and tempo. Come on, push him on. Mean it. Yes. There, that's it. That tempo right there. Good. Now push your right hand, bend it left. Push left. And back off. Good. Now close your left hand, bend to the right, your right leg, put your right leg on. Push a moment and back off. Maybe do it one more time. Good. Okay. Center line, leg heel. Let's do the first one, walking. And now walk, center line, walk, and leg heel to the right. Towards somewhere between B and P. Yeah. Good. Yes. All right. I think we can do it at trot. Go ahead, drop, center line, leg heel. So this is the same concept. Inside leg driving, outside leg restricting, making sure he's not looking to the outside. There. Good. We'll tap on it. Good. Walk. And right back to drop, center line, leg heel. Uh-huh. Good. And now move along. Make sure that he doesn't run through your right rein and just sort of charges sideways. Control it. Yes. If he does, tighten the right rein. Nice. Good there. And walk. Sit. And right back to trot. And go. Good. Okay. Big circle. Big 20-meter circle. Tiny bit more forward. More tempo. Good. And transition walk. Close your ring finger, right hand. Take. And walk. Transition walk. Good there. Take a pretty deep breath. Transition walk. Good. Again, on the leg back. And go. Close your outer hand. And walk. Do that again. Down transition. Sit. Good. March in. March in. Close your outer hand. On the leg back. And not from the trot. No, not from the tree. Keep it from the walk. Close your outer hand. Get ready. Left leg back. Yes. Okay. You can move your left leg back even further. Okay. Be a little more clear. I think with this guy, you have to be extremely clear. So, good there. Now, when you come to the open side, you're a medium canter again. Medium canter. So you push him on. Say three steps. Four. four, and then you cruise, you back off. Now go, go, and now easy, back off, and now slow down. So to slow down, you push it again.
Yeah,
slower, so that that doesn't happen.
Yeah, that's right. No, that you get angry with it sometimes.
Do that again. You can handle it. And go. Yes, and now put your leg on top of the whip to slow it down. Yes, 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 energy, and now back off.
Good, yes, look at that, how round he can be. Awesome.
One more time, medium. Come on, the biggest medium. Go. Yes.
All right.
Head down to the trot.
Leg on,
light, easy hand,
good, and tempo, tap the whip,
good there, super, really like that frame, really like that tempo,
nice, and walk, good job, little warm up, good. Very good. I know he's not the easiest horse. Yeah? And so as far as exercises that help make no. Let's start at the other end.
You understand what I'm saying, right? You have to hold it in the order, make it round, you have to hold it in front, push behind and back up. So it's a constant hold, drive, give.
Hold, drive, give.
In I don't want to say random intervals. I mean he kind of gives you the sequence in which you have to have one.
Yeah?
By the response that he gives you. Well, in the beginning, he doesn't give you much response. You just need to be here, right? He just wants to be stubborn. And so, you don't want to hold and push for very long, because then you just pull on him, and then he just gets worse, okay? But if you do it too short, then nothing ever happens. So you have to find a time, okay? You want to work your way to a place where the take and hold doesn't have to be so strong anymore. Okay, so that's teaching him, that's schooling, that's training him to respond to littler aims. In order to get him to understand that, you have to do tons of those little athletes. Yeah? When I say, okay, take at least the time that you take, every time is slightly different. Okay? Let's say it's a half a second. The next time it's 3/4 of a second. Yeah, but the half second one was very strong. The 3/4 second one was maybe only a portion of it. Then the next one is a 1/10 of a second. Then the next one is maybe 2.5 seconds. Okay, he determines what you have to do by his response. If you take and you push it, he gives it right away, you release. So that can maybe be, what, 2-3/10 of a second, like bam, and it's over. And if he doesn't respond, you may have to take a little bit longer. But you don't want to go too long. So if you take and hold and it's much longer than 3 or 4 seconds, or say 3 or 4 steps, that would be a huge long time. Yeah. Okay? So time to release. And maybe the release, it's the same is true for the release. So sometimes you release for as long as he's good, right? It's round. And if he goes like he goes at the end, you don't have to do a whole lot, right? You can maybe go for 20 meters and not do anything and be fairly light. Okay, and then you'll feel, okay, now it's starting to fall apart, it's getting a little stiff, it's getting a little sluggish, then you put them together again. Okay. Or in the beginning, that release is maybe lasts only for half a second or 1 second. Okay, so it's a take, it's release, and take again and release, and take again and release. Yeah. So it's irregular intervals. Okay, on, off, or a little bit on, not so much on.